We're doing this.
Yeah.
All right, I'm ready.
Again. So last one. So
yeah, leave the bird. It's okay. Is that it?
Hi, my name is Emeka Okereke, and this filming is in the context of the exhibition Stressing Presences of Place, Body, Time that I'm currently working on, which is slated for an opening at the Schloss Charlottenburg here in Berlin. Sometime last year, I was invited to look at two sculptures that was recently found in a depot somewhere in Potsdam. And these two sculptures are relics of the colonial past of Germany. And I was called into it as a photographer to look at the sculptures and to reflect on them. So what's interesting about these sculptures is that I think it was sometime around the 19th century, they were standing at the Ordenspalais. Since then, it has moved hands, changed locations. But what's interesting is that they were found damaged, really damaged, and no one knows how, these statues were damaged. And so this missing episode in the genealogy of the statues opened up a space for reflection, for asking questions about how did all these damages came about. They were even painted white. So what I would call a kind of whitewashing. And the whole idea is for me to come in as a photographer to look at these statues, but also to think about it in the present time. And this is the reason why I titled the exhibition Tracing Presences. I wanted to think of the statue not as an object, but rather to think of it as a cartography. So I was looking to photograph all the contours and all the textures around the statue, but also to think of a somewhat lost place or a lost cartography. And the guiding idea is that the fact that something is lost does not mean it does not exist. This thinking is very, very central to some of the post-colonial conundrums that we find ourselves in now, which is that we are looking to reimagine history. We understand that much of what colonialism did was to sidetrack or to negate history, certain kinds of history. And there is a tendency to think of all those histories as lost. But when you really think about it, that something is lost doesn't mean it doesn't exist. This is reflected on the text that opens the work, which is, we are here to nurture life, not to resurrect the dead. Because I also wanted to think of the statue not as something that is dead or ossified in the past. That this process of investigating, questioning, reflecting around the statue is in and of itself a way of nurturing life. I have allowed my gaze as a photographer, as an image maker, over these years of two decades of photographing and questioning through photography to just lead the way. The very first thing I said to myself that this is about bodies, and this, I wanted it to be about movement. I wanted the idea of multiple myriad perspectives to manifest in the way that I approach the photographing of the statue. So much of how I have also approached photographing these statues is a way of looking to articulate all of those impressions that has been as a function of me moving this body over two decades. I think that is for me the most fulfilling aspect of doing this work, in the sense that for every time I was photographing and working on the photographs, that it felt like I was also doing a lot of introspection and self-reflection. That in and of itself, the process has been very, very fulfilling and gratifying for me as an artist, as a thinking, moving body. The actual sculptures will be exhibited in the same space as my photographs. And so what the audience is going to see is a projection of my photographs interspersed with the text on a gray wall, a continuous gray wall, such that the text feels like a caption for the room when it shows up. I have people I've been collaborating with throughout the course of this project. I had a research assistant who came on board to do some research on the ground or background research. And then eventually David Esser, who came at the later part or even at the last part of it when I was thinking, oh, this needs sound. And then finally is Baz, you know, who is doing the filming, bringing all of this together as a way of putting it in a compact form to give a glimpse to the audience of the process of this project throughout the course of the 6 months.